make sure it's witch hazel, witch hazel. Use any kind of spray bottle you want. It doesn't have to look like this one. It could be one with like a handle as well. Any kind of spray bottle. I'm trying to see if these ones say what size they are. They don't really. But I believe that almost 10 ounces. I've got a little scale here. And I had weighed them right before I started the video so I could figure out how many ounces of witch hazel to add. Just need to add a quarter of the volume of witch hazel, whatever size your bottle is, just a quarter of the volume should be witch hazel, and then the rest should be distilled water. So I just filled my bottle up with water, weighed it, and then I weighed bottle empty and subtracted the weight of the empty bottle and then divided that number by 4 and I got 2.4. So I need 2.4 ounces of witch hazel. And then this is optional. I just find it easier to pour out of a little measuring cup, then out of the distilled water bottle, straight into these tiny bottles. So I like to pour it in here first and then use the spout, but you don't have to. optional, but I like to put a label on the bottle so I know what scent is in there. I get these off of Amazon. This like giant roll. I think it was a 500 stickers was $9.99 on Amazon. And they have all kinds of designs. I liked this one, so I got this set, but they have all kinds of designs you can pick from. So I put these on these sprays, and I'll also put them on like spice mixes that I give as gifts. So I'm gonna do one of these bottles. I'm gonna do the Be Calm essential oil, and then the other bottle I'm gonna do a mixture of the tangerine, lemon, and rose. So I'm gonna write the names on these and put them on the bottles. So I'm gonna call the first one Be Calm, because that's the name of the essential oil, and then I'm just gonna call the other one Citrus Twist, because it's like lemon and tangerine, which is citrus, and then the rose is the twist. Obviously, you can call yours whatever you want. So I'm gonna just put this on the bottle. These make little great gifts as well. Okay, so let's do the witch hazel in both bottles first. I'm just gonna take the entire cap off. And I have my little scale down here. So I'm gonna put the measuring cup on here. And then I'll zero it out. And then I can add 2.4 ounces of the witch hazel. Okay, so there's one. It's okay if it's not like exact. It could be an, you know, 0.2 ounces. It's not a big deal. So now I'll pour it into the bottle. Thank you. So now I can add the essential oils. Let's put the cap on this so it doesn't spill everywhere. And I'm going to do the pecan one first. And this size of bottle. Ooh, let's weigh it. Actually, let's see. How much do you weigh now? Okay, so it's a 10-ounce bottle. So this size bottle needs 30 drops. 30 drops of any essential oil you want. So for this one, it's going to be 30 drops of just this. The Dollar Tree has these bottles like over by the hair care section. I think it's supposed to be for like water to wet your hair down to do like different hairstyles. But they work super great for this as well. And they have all different colors. Like they have this, you know, bright gold. They have this bronzy color. They have an even rosier, like rose gold. They have a silver. And I have seen a black. It's like a sparkly metallic black like this. But it is hard to find these, like, gold and bronzy ones are way easier to find than the black. For some reason. Basically any like season you can pick your essential oils to fit, and in my opinion lavender is always a good one because you need pillow spray like any time of the year, and lavender is also a really common popular scent for laundry, so those ones are always liked by the majority of people. But guys, that was everything I had to show you in today's video. I hope that you enjoyed